Once we have understood how to measure current and voltages, there are only few things that need to be explained further. The next thing that we are going to discuss is concept of ground. So in any electronic circuit, you might have seen something like this. I have this battery. This is positive terminal of battery, negative terminal of battery. And this is connected to a resistance, simple circuit. Let's say this is R1, this is voltage V, and sometime it might be shown something like this, or you might also observe something like this. This is a plus 5 volt supply and something like this. What is this symbol is? What does this symbol mean? This symbol is called as ground. But what does it mean actually? What do we mean by ground terminal? Ground terminal means this is a common terminal. You measure voltages with respect to this particular point. So potentials or voltage is measured with respect to this point, ground. What I mean by that? What I mean is that if I measure the voltage anywhere, let's say I want to measure between this particular point and this particular point, then I will connect it something like this, or even if I can connect it something like this, voltmeter, and I can connect it to common ground. Okay, it is supposed, this point is supposed to have a potential equal to zero, but that's not actually the case. Over here, since I have shown ground terminal over here, this is not at zero potential. Actually, it is at this particular potential. Okay? So, this is a concept of ground. So, you measure the voltages with respect to this particular point. But this is not an actual zero potential. This might be at some different potential. But for all practical purposes, for a given circuit, we can consider it to be at a zero potential, and we can, since it is at a zero potential, we can measure the potential of any point with respect to this particular point. Now that said, now we are going to discuss about our next concept, which is series and parallel connections of resistances. So what is this series and parallel connection of resistance? So suppose I have these two resistances with me. This is R1 and another resistance R2. Now I can connect them to each other something like this. Either I can have R1 connected to R2 something like this, and these two, another two A terminals, they are connected somewhere else. So R1 and R2 are connected back to back. So when current flows through this particular terminal, the same current that is flowing through R1 will be flowing through R2. Such a connection is known as series connection. And in series connection, same current flows through both resistances. This is very important. You have the same current in series connection. So in a circuit, if some resistances are in series, then the current flowing through them will be same. Is it always true? What I mean it by some it is that, suppose I have two resistances connected in circuit, something like this. Something like this, and they are again connected somewhere else, and the current flowing through this resistance, let me call it as R1, and this is at R2, is again I1. So the current flowing through R1 and R2 is same. Are they in series? No, this is not a series connection. You're getting my point. This is not a series connection, so it is not a sufficient condition. If the same current flows through R1 and R2, then it's not sufficient to say that these two are connected in series. Another condition to confirm is that they should be connected back to back. Are they connected back to back? No, they are not connected back to back. So this is series connection. As we proceed, you will understand what is series connection and parallel connection. So the next connection of this R1 and R2, I can connect them something like this. I can have this R1 and I can have this R2. So both the terminals of R1 and R2 are connected together. If I have something like this, then this is called as parallel connection. Right? Now if some amount of current is flowing inside this particular circuit, let's say I, then this resistance, through this resistance a current I1 will flow, and through this resistance current I2 will flow. So in this particular case, most of the time I1 is not equal to I2, and I1 will be equal to I2 for this particular case if and only if R1 is equal to R2. So in parallel connections, the current flowing through the resistance may be different. I am using a word may. Most of the time it is different. So let's look at this particular series and parallel connection, and let's find out how we can find out the total resistance. So we have something like this. Suppose I have a circuit something like this. I have a battery which is providing a potential V. I have this resistance, another resistance, and let's say third resistance. So let me call them R1, R2, R3, and a current is flowing. Since this is the current, the same current, these are, see, now this I is going through this particular resistance as well, and this current is also going through this resistance as well. So this connection is series connection, because same amount of current is flowing through them. You might ask why this is not a series connection. It was the same, right? Similar. This is not series because I can write it something like this. So if this is R1, this is R2, and this is R3, then I can show it something like this. This is R1, this is R2, and this is R3. Now R1 and R2 are in series, but they are in parallel with R1. That's why it is not there. So if it is connected somewhere else, see, so the current is coming through this particular point. So the current is coming something like this, and it is leaving from this particular point. So the current is leaving through this particular point. So it is getting divided. This will be I1 and this will be I2. Here the same amount of current will flow from R1, R2 and R3, but different current will flow through R1. Okay, so this is parallel connection. And this is series connection because the same amount of current is flowing. And one end is both, not both the ends are connected. Here, see, both ends are connected. These R2 and R2, R2, R3 are in series, and they are their both ends, this end and this end. This is the series resistance connection. These are connected to R1, both terminals. So this is parallel connection and this is series connection. Now if I have something like this series connection, then the same current is flowing and the total voltage drop, since this is a closed circuit, the total voltage drop, as we have seen, total voltage drop will be equal to the voltage supply. So total voltage drop, which is equal to current flowing through the circuit multiplied by the total resistance, is equal to I R1 plus I2, sorry, this is I R2 plus I R3. Since same amount of current is flowing, the total voltage drop will be voltage drop across R1 plus voltage drop across R2 plus voltage drop across R3. So I R1 plus I R2 plus I R3 will be my total voltage drop. So I can take I common, and I am going to get I RT is equal to I R1 plus R2 plus R3. I will get cancelled and the total resistance will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So in order to find the equivalent resistance or the total resistance for a series circuit, you just need to add the individual resistance values R1 plus R2 plus R3. Even if they are very large number of resistances, it will be same. What will happen if I have a parallel circuit? If I have a parallel circuit, something like this, suppose I have a battery and this battery is connected to, this is R1, and this is R2. See, different amount of current will flow through them, right? If this is I and this is I1 and I2, different amount of current is flowing and their both ends are connected together. So they are in parallel, right? So what is the amount of current that is flowing through this particular, the total amount of current I will be equal to I1 plus I2. And the voltage drop across R1 and R2, since they are connected in parallel, will be same. So if I have a parallel connection, voltage drop will be same. For series, what we have? For series, current flowing is same. So for series, the current is same, and for parallel, voltage is same. Now since voltage drop across R1 and R2 is same, I can write V is equal to I1 R1. And also I can write V is equal to I2 R2, because the voltage drop across both the resistance is same. And I have I1 plus I2 is equal to I. So, and the voltage supplied will be I R total. So this will give me this particular equation will give me I is equal to V divided by RT, which is equal to I1. I1 will be equal to what? Voltage divided by R1 plus what is the current flowing through second resistance R2? The voltage drop across the resistance divided by the resistance value. This is Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. Using this, I will be equal to V by R. And since these voltages are same, we can cancel it out, and I am going to get 1 over RT is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. This is the total resistance for parallel circuits in a series connection. Can I find what is the voltage drop across R1 and R2 in terms of, if I don't know, let's say the current? Yes, obviously I can find it out, since the total resistance is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. The current flowing through the circuit is equal to V by RT, which is equal to V divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the current value, right? Now, if I want to find out what is the voltage drop across R1, it will be simply R1 into I, which will be equal to R1 into V divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3. So I need not know what is the amount of current, actual amount of current flowing through the circuit. Even if I know only voltages and resistance values, I can find out what is the voltage drop across each resistances, and I can also calculate what is the amount of current flowing. Similarly, over here in a parallel circuit, can I find out what is the amount of current flowing through I1 and I2? Sorry, R1 and R2. What is the amount? What is the value of I1 and what is the value of I2? It's very simple actually. It will be equal to this. I1 is equal to this will be my I1 and this will be my I2. So these are series, about series and parallel connection, and how you can find out the resistances. The last concept that I am going to discuss is potential divider arrangement. In this potential divider arrangement, now you will realize how helpful the ground symbol is in representing a circuit. So suppose I have a circuit something like this, and I connected, let's say, three resistances in series. So this will be R1, R2 and R3, and this is voltage V. Potential difference, this battery is providing a potential difference of V. I can simply write this circuit as something like this. This is a potential V, this is R1, this is R2 and this is R3, right? Now when current flows through this particular thing, what we are going to get? The total voltage drop across R3 will be equal to V3. The voltage drop across R2 will be equal to V2, and the voltage drop across R1 will be V1, right? The voltage drop across R2 and R3 will be V2 plus V3, and the total voltage drop will be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, which is equal to V, correct? Is it clear? Now let's talk about some example. Let's talk about some values. Suppose this is 15 volt and all these R1, R2 and R3, they are, let's say, 500 ohm. Okay. So the voltage drop across R1 will be equal to voltage drop across R2 will be equal to voltage drop across R3, because the same amount of current is flowing through them and they have the same values, right? So in this particular case, the voltage drop across R3 will be 5 volt, voltage drop across R2 will be 5 volt, and voltage drop across R1 will be 5 volt, and the total voltage drop will be 15 volt. So if I draw that circuit over here, this is 15 volt, and I have R1 which is equal to 500 ohm, and I am getting a connection through over here. Let me call it as connection A. This is R2 which is again 500 ohm, and I am getting a connection out of over here which is B, and this is R3 which is again 500 ohm, and this is ground. So if I measure voltage across this point B and ground, I am going to get 5 volt. However, if I measure voltage from point A to ground, I am going to get voltage of 5 volt across this R2 and 5 volt across R3, so that would be 10 volt. And if I measure from this particular point, this will be 5 volt across this particular thing, 5 volt across this R2 and 5 volt across this R3. So if I measure this across this terminal and ground, obviously it will be 15 volt. So what I have done over here, I have divided whatever power supply I have with me into different voltage source. So if I connect this particular terminal and ground, I am going to get 5 volt. If I connect this particular point and ground, I am going to get 10 volt. And if I connect this particular point and ground, obviously I am going to get 15 volt. So here, as you know, this ground is the negative terminal of a battery. This is a common point. This is not a zero potential part, right? So this is what is potential divided arrangement is. Thank you. Thank you for your time.